Hello and welcome, and in this session we are going to learn functions and variables in JMeter. This is going to be very easy and very interesting, and we are going to go very basic and we will learn what are functions, what are variables, and how to use functions and variables. I will also show you the syntax. So in JMeter we can use a lot of functions and variables, and if I have to define functions in JMeter, I can say these are methods used to populate fields in any other element of a test plan. And the syntax is, I will say dollar and then curly brackets and double underscore and the function name. Let me highlight it with a different color. So this is the syntax, and in a moment I will show you this is very easy. Do not think that this is going to be difficult. I will also show you how exactly you can get help on functions directly in JMeter. And the other syntax is, if you also are using any variables, you can say function name and in brackets I can give the variables, for example variable 1, variable 2, and so on. And I will show you an example in a moment. So this is what function is, and this is how we use functions in JMeter. Now when I talk about variables, so variables are containers that can store values which can be referred in any element within a thread. So within a thread, if you want to refer any value, you can store it into a variable and then can refer it at any other location or element within that thread. And the syntax will be, so it is almost the same. We will use dollar and then curly brackets, and then we give the variable name, whatever name we have stored or used, we will give the variable name like this. Now let us go to JMeter and see how can we use functions and variables. I have a new test plan. I will right click and create a thread group, and let me create any sampler. I can use a very simple sampler like a Java request. Now here let us say we want to log something. So there is a function called log, and I can go to options, and you will see here, no, you have to go to tools, and under tools you will see this function helper dialog. You can go from here or can press Ctrl Shift F1, or you can also see there is a direct icon here, function helper dialog on your JMeter toolbar. So I will go here, and you can see this is a function helper dialog, and in this drop down you can see all these functions that you can use. And let me search for log. As I type log, I have got this function here, and then you can see all these details about the function. You can give the values here and can generate the function which you can copy directly from here. And I can also go to this help. It will take me to the documentation of this function and will show me how exactly to use this function. So for now I will say log here, and let us say I want to log something, say hello world, and I do not want this log level as of now. I will click on generate and copy, and you can see it has generated the function for me directly, and I can just use it from here. It also shows me what will be the result of this function, and now I can close this. And here in place of my name of this sampler, that is Java request, I am just copying this function. So it is saying log hello world, and let me also add a listener to see the result. I will add view results tree, and now I will save this. I will save functions and variables.jmx, and I will run this and see. So you can see in place of name it has logged hello world. Now I can also use functions along with some static data. For example, I can say here request space and this function which is logging hello world. And of course, because I am not using the other parameters, I can remove these extra commas from here and this should still work. I will save and run again, and now you will see it is saying request and then appending whatever is the result of the function. Now I can go and see some more functions. I will again go to the function helper dialog, and let us see time function. So if I go here, time, here I can give the format. You can always go to the help, but here you can see I can give the format of the time. Let us say I want to have a time in DD MM YY YY, and I will say generate and copy, and now I will add one more sampler for a Java request, and in place of name, I am adding this function. Now, I am just adding all these functions in the name for this demo only, just to show you how functions work and what will be the output. In real world, you will need to use them wherever you need in your elements or requests. So let me now take this up, and again I will save and I will clear everything and run. And now you can see it is showing me the current date here. If I also want the time, I can just go here and say that I also want a time in hours, minutes and seconds format. So this is HHMMSS. And that's it. I will save and run again. And now you can see it is also going showing me the date and time. Then I will see some more functions. I will go to function helper dialog and let us say some thread function. So you can see we have thread group, thread num. Let us see thread num here. And this is a function which will show me the current thread. And this can be useful while you are doing your performance testing. Let me copy this and I will create a new sampler to demo this, a Java request, and I will just add this thread num, and also let me append something. I will say thread num space whatever will be the number of the thread, and to see some real output, I will go to my thread group and increase the count of users to 5 so that I can see the thread number. And now I will save and run and check. So you can see here it is saying here thread number 1, then here it is thread number 2, thread number 3, 4 and 5. So if you want to log the thread numbers in your result, you can use this. I can also get a machine name or machine IP. You can see machine IP and machine name is here. So this will be useful if you are doing a kind of distributed testing where you have multiple systems running the performance test, and in the result you may want to know what machine or IP was used to run a particular request. In that case, you can use a machine name or machine IP. Then there are some functions like int sum. So let us see int sum. I can give a number here. I can say 2 here and 3 and say generate and copy. This generates a function to do integer addition of 2 and 3. Let us say I add this here, and let me go back to the thread group and just keep the thread count to 1. And also I will disable these other samplers. And now if I run, you can see in the report, in the result, I am getting the addition of 2 and 3, that is 5. Also, let us say if I want to store this in a variable, I can say here, I can give a variable name, say result. So this will be stored in the variable result, and this variable now I can use anywhere in my within my thread. So for example, I go to the next request. Let me enable it again. And here I'm just going to use this variable. So to use the variable, we know the syntax is dollar, and within curly brackets we use the variable name, that is result in this case. So let us see what happens. I will save, go to the result, clear all and run. And you can see at both the places I am getting 5, because here it was the addition and here we have referred the result of the addition which was stored in the variable called result. Now I can also say here, I can actually again do a again call the integer sum underscore underscore int sum is the function, and then here I can say I want to add 2, and then instead of giving a hard-coded value for the second number, I am referring the variable. So I can say dollar, and within curly brackets I can say result, which stores the value of addition from the first request, and then that's it. I will close this function. So here it should add 2 to the result of the earlier addition, that is 5, so we should get 7 here. So let us see. I will save, clear and run, and yes, you can see we are getting 5 and 7. So this is how you can use functions and variables, and this is very handy. You can always go to the function helper dialog and see what kind of function you want, and you can get it from here. You can always go to help, it will take you to the documentation. And if you go to the JMeter website, that is jmeter.apache.org, and go to user manual, and here Under point number 20, you have functions, and you can see all these functions are here. So you can always check from here what all functions are available and what is their use and how you can use it. All the documentation is here, and you can then use all these functions and variables in your test. I hope this was useful. Thank you for watching.